virgin shall conceive. Isaiah 7 and verse 14. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. Isaiah 9 verse 6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. This week we've been tracing some of the key prophecies through the Old Testament that foretell the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Isaiah the prophet is probably one of the foremost prophets with numerous prophecies concerning the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, what he would do, what he would even accomplish on the cross, and so on. And in the two prophecies of Isaiah that we read, Isaiah clearly pinpoints to the birth of Jesus Christ. He says, a virgin will conceive and bear a child, and will call his name Emmanuel. And sure enough, we see in Matthew chapter 1, when Jesus was born, it looks back at this prophecy of Isaiah and says, the birth of Jesus, that's the fulfillment of Isaiah's prophecy. And Isaiah continues to say, chapter 9, he says, this son who is born, this son who is given, he says, the government will be on his shoulder, and he'll be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. And we know in Isaiah 9 and verse 6, the first part of that prophecy has been fulfilled. The child has been born. The son has been given. And we know that the latter part of that prophecy is yet to be fulfilled, will be fulfilled when he comes to rule and reign. The government is upon his shoulder, and he's literally taking on the rulership of the world. Now, Isaiah foretold the coming of the Messiah, of the Lord Jesus Christ. This is some 700 plus years, you know, some estimated as 750 or 760 years before Jesus came into this world, that Isaiah foretold with such accuracy, with such precision about the birth of Jesus Christ. You know, we stand in awe of God who foretold to the mouth of his prophets the coming of Jesus into this world. And there is no doubt that this one, the Messiah who was born, Jesus who was born, this one Jesus, this one person fulfilled each and every prophecy that was given before time about him. And that makes it so unique. The probability that one man in the entire history of humankind would fulfill all of these numerous prophecies in various details about him, that one man to fulfill all these prophecies, the probability was so slim. And yet we see that Jesus Christ, in his birth, in his life on earth, in his death, in his resurrection, he fulfilled all of these prophecies that were given concerning him. We stand in awe. It just makes us stand in awe of how great, how wonderful our God is. We worship him. Let's pray. Father, we thank you that we serve you, God who is so awesome, God who is so wonderful, so powerful, that you would speak well ahead of time to the mouth of your servants, the mouth of your prophets, and they would pinpoint, they would speak with such accuracy, with such detail on various aspects of the coming of Jesus Christ. Oh God, we stand in awe of this. We stand in awe of your works. We stand in awe of the way in which you do things. And we honor you. And we thank you for our Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.